Hi, for those of you who don't know me, my name is Abigail Niederer, and I am part of the freshman class this year at Doc. For Arts Day, I decided to do a dance to the song A Million Dreams from the movie The Greatest Showman. This song connects to the theme Imagine If because the lyrics talk about imagining a world where all your dreams can become a reality and how you can make that world happen in your own life. I hope you enjoy.
I close my eyes and I can see a world that's waiting up for me, that I call my own. Through the dark, through the door, through where no one's been before, but it feels like home. They can say it all sounds crazy. They can say I've lost my mind. I don't care, so call me crazy. We can live in a world that we desire. There's a house we can build. Every room inside is filled with things from far away. Special things I compile, each one there to make you smile on a rainy day. They can say it all sounds crazy. They can say we've lost our minds. I don't care if they call us crazy. Run away to a world that we design.
Every night I lie in bed, the brightest colors fill my head. A million dreams keeping me. For the world we're gonna make.
However big, however small, let me be part of it all. Share your dreams with me. You may be right, you may be wrong, but say that you'll bring me along to the world you see,
to the world I close my eyes.
The brightest colors fill my head.
A million dreams are keeping me
awake. A million dreams.
I think of what the world could be. A vision of.
Hi, I am Olivia Moyer, and I'm a freshman here at Dock. For Arts Day this year, I chose to do photography. The first photo is a picture of a fence with snow on it, and the second photo is a picture of a plant covered with snow. I chose to take pictures of these two things because both really capture the beauty of nature and snow. Both pictures connect to the theme Imagine If because they show what winter is like and what it looks like. So I thought of it as this. Imagine if winter and snow never existed. What would our world look like? That is how my two photos connect to the theme of Imagine If. I hope you like my two photos. Thank you.
Hi everyone, I'm Anna Smith, and Abigail Niederer, Eliana Farmer, and I all worked together to put together and perform the song Lost Boy by Ruth B. This song talks about the story of Peter Pan and how imagining stories in our head can be a comfort in a time of loneliness. Ruth B. sings about her adventures with Peter Pan and the Lost Boys and how, even though they are just a fairy tale, they are her family. Through Lost Boys' poetic lyrics, we realize that as long as we have our imagination, we will never truly be lonely. Please enjoy Lost Boy, played by Eliana Farmer, choreographed by Abigail Niederer, and sung by myself.
Sometimes you would go away too. Hey everyone, my name is Ainsley Moyer, and this year I got to create a pencil skirt in Fabrics and Fashions. I created this skirt using a plaid sort of material, and I created it to have a zipper going down the side with a hook and eye at the top, and two darts on either side of it. My skirt connects to the theme because I never would have imagined that I could create something so difficult and cool. It took lots of imagination and work to create this piece, but I am very pleased with how it came out. This was only possible because I wondered if I could make a skirt, and then I made my vision come alive.
Hi everyone, I'm Emily, and I wrote a poem called The Weight of Our Words. I wrote this poem around the basis of, can you imagine if the words we said held no weight? My thinking was, what if what we said and the words we used didn't matter? Or they didn't hurt somebody, or they didn't mean something to someone. I think this idea is very different from the world we live in today. So it was kind of one of those things where it's like, can you imagine? Like, what would the world look like? And like, what would that mean to us? Can you imagine if the words we said held no weight? The gravity of our speech was non-existent. All the anger and fear they can carry relinquished. The words that cut deeper than a knife don't hurt anymore. But then, the splendor and joy of them goes away, and the moments we share because of them become less and less, like sand sinking through an hourglass. We would no longer tear people down with them, but then we also wouldn't lift people up. Our verbs would take no action, our nouns would have no subject, our adjectives wouldn't describe. Speech is silver and silence is golden, but what does that mean when the silver and gold are worth the same? Our words have consequences, but when the sun sets, it could all go away. And then, just for a moment, the weight of our words fades away. Can you imagine?
Hi, my name is Steven Liu, and my visual art piece is called Visible Time. Can you imagine if time is visible? We usually associate time with the present and the past, but what if time is tangible, visible, and sensible? In my painting, I used hourglass aurora and acrylic pouring as inspiration to create this visible time. In the choice of color, I chose blue to represent gloomy time, black represents dead time, red represents painful time, and yellow represents golden time.
Hi, I'm Haley, and for Arts Day this year, I chose to make a heart cake.
For Arts Day this year, I chose to make a cake to represent love. When I think of the theme, I can imagine, I think of the broad concept of love, whether that be from friends or family, or more importantly, God's love. God's love is so unconditional and unwavering, sometimes it's hard to imagine that anyone could love us that much. To know and understand God's love is hard, but very rewarding.
For this cake, I made a vanilla batter dyed pink and iced with Swiss meringue buttercream. It is in the shape of a heart and is decorated with the color pink, which we often associate with love. It is ombre on the sides and has a decorative border on the top. Finally, on the outside, there are white buttercream hearts around the bottom.
Hi, my name is Emily O'Rourke, and this is my visual arts project. It's titled Forever Friendless. Can you imagine a world without friendship? It would be pretty lonely and sad. Friends have our backs in the darkest days when we need them most. True friends never abandon us during the rough times and are fun to be with in the happy times. I tried to show how lonely it would be without friends by showing her head down, an empty background, and an empty swing.
Hi, I'm Emma, and I'm a sophomore. And I decided to write a poem about nature for Arts Day. This connects to the theme of Can You Imagine? Because nature has the power to transform our minds. Nature is very powerful and can be used to represent so many things. Because of this, it opens us up to new possibilities that we could have never thought of before. I want to thank you for giving me your attention, and now I'm going to read my poem, The Glorious Earth.
I rise with the golden sun. I sway with a gentle breeze. I grow with the new buds of spring. I flow with the cool streams. I move with the nature around me, and I have to ask myself, can you imagine a life without it? I feel warmth wrapping around me. Colors fade from purple to pink, pink to red, red to orange, orange to yellow, yellow to white. The sun casts out its blinding rays across the world. The earth awakens around me, acknowledging the presence of something bigger, something warmer, something more powerful than itself. The sun draws the earth out of the darkness of night, and I have to ask myself, can you imagine a life without it? The wind brushes past me, moving leaves, blades of grass, petals of flowers, and everything in its path. My hair whips around my face, fighting to cover my eyes. I feel a cold chill around my body, raising the hair on my arms, causing me to cling to myself for warmth. I see birds in flight, carried away to distant locations. Dandelion puffs dispersed on the ground, hoping to create new life wherever they land. The wind stirs the earth, and I have to ask myself, can you imagine a life without it? Life is all around me, through the young buds and blossoms on flowers and trees, the bright green of sprouting grass, and small animals trying to survive their first years. Everything glows with newness and prosperity. The universe feels open, unifying, almost like it's inviting you to witness it in all of its glory. Rebirth among all creatures for all the world to see. I take in the beautiful sights of spring, and I have to ask myself, can you imagine a life without it? Cold water rushes past my ankles. My feet touch the muddy riverbed, trying to avoid rocks as I trek through the creek. Water flows past me, twisting and turning around bends and crevices, whispering its secrets to everything it encounters as it travels downstream. This creek carries stories, memories, hopes, and dreams as it flows towards an endless horizon. I am overcome by the powerful emotion of the creek, and I have to ask myself, can you imagine a life without it? My answer is no. This place is too near and dear to my heart to watch it fade away. I cannot bear the thought of leaving it behind, so I must take it with me. Bring the light, bring the power, bring the life, and bring the emotion. Spread it throughout the world and share it with all. The glorious earth nourishes our mind, body, and soul. Without it, there is no life. So we must work together to keep it alive. Because if I cannot imagine a life without it, how can you?
Hi, my name is Celeste, and we are in class 2023.
Hi, and I'm Tiffany. We made a two-layer chocolate cake with strawberry buttercream frosting, and on the top of the cake you'll notice some flowery designs hand-piped by Celeste.
So, to incorporate the theme of Can You Imagine in our cake, we'd like the judges to think, can you imagine how our cake might have turned out if it was actually good?
Okay, judges, we're gonna need you to use your imagination for this next part. Think of the potential our cake has. Imagine it in your head, and then judge that cake.
Hi everyone, I'm Michaela Davis and I'm a sophomore and I'm going to show you the rings that I've created for Arts Day this year.
For Arts Day this year, I created 5 handmade rings. They're made out of wire and each one has a different charm. My rings connect to the theme Imagine because while I was making them, I imagined various Disney princesses wearing them. For example, the shell ring is something I can imagine Ariel wearing, and the ring with 3 blue stones is one I can imagine Cinderella wearing. Can you imagine what Disney princesses would wear the other 3?
Okay, so this is my poem. It's a rhyme and it makes me feel good. The sun comes through the clouds, found in the sky. People always wish that they could fly. Get caught in the wind, feel the breeze. I'm just wondering how the fall could hurt my knees.
Oh.
The birds chirp all around. The one missing could not be found. Oh. Gloomy and dark, the dog goes bark. People finally found the bird at dark. Thank you.
Hi everyone, I'm Emily and this is my fabric arts project. So I created a stuffed kite with some Mary Poppins fabric, some blue ribbon, I braided some twine for the kite string, and I put some blue bows on the bottom.
In the new movie, Mary Poppins Returns, there's a song called Can You Imagine That? And one of my favorite parts reads, "Some people like to laugh at life and giggle through the day. They think the world's a brand new shiny toy. And if while dreaming in the clouds, they fall and go kersplat. Although they're down and bent in half, they brush right off and start to laugh. Can you imagine that?"
I really like these lyrics because even though they're a little bit innocent and naive, I think there's something in them that myself and a lot of other people strive for. Just the positivity and like the happy attitude that Mary Poppins has and like we feel when we watch her and characters like her. Mary Poppins is a very personal connection for me and some of my family members. So it's just one of those things where I'm like, can you imagine that? Like seeing the world that we live in, you know, if somebody like Mary Poppins or anything along that line walked around in our lives, like somebody like that affecting us, I just love the idea of that.
Hey guys, my name is Marlies, and me, along with Ainsley Moyer, Sophia Locker, Micah Mast, and Matthias Brockington, will be singing for you guys Imagine by John Lennon. It's a very popular song, so most of you probably know it. The song connects with the theme, first off, because it is titled Imagine. It also connects because throughout the whole song, it talks about imagining a place where something happens that will resolve some type of conflict. Putting all these examples together would create a world full of peace and unity. So, we hope you like the song.
Imagine there's no heaven. It's easy if you try. No hell below us. Above us only sky. Imagine all the people.
Absence of Color by Eli Ottifer.
Can you imagine a world with no color? No judgment based on race, just simply black, white, and gray. Two shades not so different from each other. Imagine a world where we could all respect and love one another for who we are, not who we look like. A world where we didn't have to protest for others to get along with each other. Just a small planet where colors had no meaning.
Hi, I'm Steven. For this year's Arts Day, I chose to make a galaxy cake. When I first think about the theme imagination, I think of the galaxy. In our impression, the galaxy is so inaccessible and mysterious. It can also be aesthetic, secret, and inviolable. Since it is so far away from us, so I wonder, wouldn't it be interesting if it is right in front of you? Can we imagine that a galaxy far away from the Earth can one day be on a cake? In the process of making, I first used a chocolate cake as the base, touch the cream on the top, and cover the cream with a layer of glaze. For the glaze part, I used gelatin powder to create the texture of the jelly, added some food colorings to make it realistic, and finally decorated with some edible gold powder and colorful pearls.
Hi, my name is Tess Jones. The visual arts piece I created is called Our Guiding Light. As soon as I saw the theme, I wasn't sure what to do until I saw the quote, "Sunflowers follow the sun, but did you know when it's cloudy and gray, they face each other and share their energy? Imagine if people did this." That's when I knew I needed to create this piece. The world is such a chaotic place filled with so much hate, especially in recent times. Imagine how much better the world would be if we all stepped back from our own lives for a second and cared for each other. Personally, this quote means much more to me. Recently, one of my best friends, Jaden, had passed away. Jaden is the sun and light for his friends and family. Right now, it's cloudy and gray without him, so we're turning to each other to provide a light and share our energy with one another. This is something that we should all strive to do each and every day. Thank you for your time.
I'm Lydia Longacre and I'm in 11th grade. Do you love a good breakfast cake? Imagine a classic fluffy vanilla cake with a nicely swirled dark golden brown top floating on a gooey chocolatey filling in a flaky pie crust. On the outside, it appears to be a pie, but once cut, the cake and lava-like chocolate filling is a surprise. Funny cake seems like many desserts mixed together, pie, cake, and fudgy chocolate. Just hearing about it makes it difficult to imagine. Yet this delicious Pennsylvania Dutch staple is a wonderful blend of flavors. When one sees a funny cake being baked, she can't help but imagine how the chocolate, which is poured over top of the cake, is found under the cake when it is cut. Yet it happens, making the funny cake come to life. Our world seems crazy right now, with strife and disease. Sometimes it is hard to imagine how things can ever turn out all right. But if we look at the funny cake and all that goes into it, we see a mix of desserts and steps that make it seem as though you would end up with a mess. But it turns into a breakfast treat that is simple and stands the test of time. This can make it easier to imagine a world with differences and problems could become tranquil and harmonious.
The theme of this year's Arts Day is Can You Imagine? When you look at this cake, it's decorated with tons of sweet and citrusy fruits, but could you only imagine what would be on the inside? When you cut open the cake, it's a four-layered vanilla sponge cake with lime, strawberry, and lemon buttercream frosting in between. The whole cake is encased in plain vanilla buttercream and garnished with strawberries, kiwis, raspberries, lemons, limes, key limes, and lemon zest. The ingredients in the cake are as follows: eggs, granulated sugar, all-purpose flour, baking powder, salt, whole milk, unsalted butter, vanilla extract, powdered sugar, lemon, strawberries, lime, raspberries, key limes, and gold kiwi.
Hey guys, I'm David, and me and Tamir are going to perform a song called Stuck on You by Giveon. And pretty much in this song, he's talking about an ex that he had. And in the beginning, it talks about a meetup that they had after they had broken up. And he kind of wants to keep it a secret. Wants her to keep it a secret and not tell anyone. And he's later on, he starts talking about how, like, he thinks his friends are going to judge him for it, for still wanting to be with her and stuff. And they're kind of seeing how that's harming him. And so, like, I kind of think that Giveon's, like, the, like, behind the song, like, he's kind of saying, imagine if I was still with her and, like, imagine, like, what we could be and stuff. Because he's obviously still trying to be with her. And, yeah, hope you guys enjoy.
Clara Benner, class of 2022. I made a chocolate-filled orange vodka for Arts Day this year, and the reason that I made this was because before you bake the bread, you roll up the dough with your chocolate filling, and then once you get your roll, then you cut down the center of it and then twist those two pieces that you get. And then once you bake the bread, this creates a really cool design on the inside, and you like can never really imagine what it's gonna look like. And another cool thing is like each piece that you cut is always different, and so that's really cool and unimaginable. Yeah, thanks.
We'll be right back. Hi, my name is Maggie Dell. I'm a junior, and the song you're about to hear is I'm Still Standing by Elton John, sung by me and accompanied on piano by Laurel Lapp. I'm Still Standing is a song about having the strength to overcome your demons and conquer your hardships in life. Elton John struggled with severe addictions to drugs and alcohol, but eventually had the strength to recover from those addictions and has been sober for about 30 years. Can you imagine having the strength to keep making music and to keep working after hitting your lowest point? Can you imagine battling so many addictions and still having the courage to share your life and vulnerabilities with the world? I hope you enjoy the song.
My name is Savannah and I am a junior. For our stay this year, I decided to make a three-tier cake with pink roses made of buttercream. For this year's theme, Can You Imagine?, I decided to incorporate a quote from one of the most imaginative people in history, Walt Disney. The quote says, "Laughter is timeless, imagination has no age, and dreams are forever." For the decorative border, I decided to shape it as small Mickey heads. This cake is made up of chocolate cake batter and decorated with fondant.
Hello, my name is Catherine Wenzel, and I'm a junior. My piece, Wonder, relates to the theme, Can You Imagine?, because it is something no one has or ever will do. Therefore, it creates a lot of thoughts and stirs your imagination. My writing talks mainly about butterflies and their transformation from caterpillar to a beautiful, colorful insect with wings. I mostly focused on the fact that they can fly. We may be able to do so in an airplane, by parasailing, and other ways, but we ourselves cannot fly. It is something that seems magical, peaceful, and most importantly, freeing. Flying is something that is hard, but not impossible to imagine doing. Wonder. Butterflies fill me with wonder, curiosity, astonishment, and surprisingly, jealousy. If I could choose to be in any animal, a butterfly would rank extremely high, if not first, on my list. I have always been fascinated by butterflies and their natural God-given beauty. There are various colors, sizes, and species. It is insane to think how they start as mere caterpillars, stuck to crawl on the ground from place to place. Caterpillars are not necessarily beautiful, nor do they fill me with amazement. They are kind of just there and glanced over, but once they become a butterfly, they get attention. I admit I'm guilty of this act myself, and there's nothing wrong with it. It is just interesting to ponder upon. During the spring, and especially the summer months, is when I see many butterflies. I watch them glide away at my house, around the Quakertown pool, in town, and everywhere in between. It is incredible to watch and observe them. One of the most common butterflies around here is the monarch butterfly. I often see the orange and black color of its wings as it flies away. Butterflies make me jealous because of their beauty, colorfulness, and their ability to fly. They have the package deal. Can you imagine what it would be like to fly? Oh, I believe it would be scary at first, but it would turn into true amazement. Flying looks so freeing and graceful. Butterflies, birds, and other creatures that fly make it look so easy, but is it? I'm not too sure about that. I can imagine being a light, graceful, beautiful butterfly gliding across the bright blue skies. I would feel weightless, relaxed, at peace, warm from the sun glowing down upon me, and most importantly, free. I would feel absolute and positively free. It would be a sensation and experience like no other. Thank you.
Hi guys, I am Dylan from class 2022. Today, I'd like to show you guys my artwork, fantasy. Please take a look. This is my artwork, fantasy. Since the topic for this project is can you imagine, so I just ask myself, what can I imagine? So, I imagine two phone became a wormhole, and people can actually enter the phone and connect with each other, although they are, different language, different country, different culture, just you and me, right? Because I am in China, you guys are in the United States, but we can still connect with each other, having class together, share our artwork together through the internet. So that is my fantasy, actually, yes. And they got two Chinese characters, which just means Wei, Lai, is future. So I think it's pretty cool to combine the Chinese and the some cool element together. And this is a planet, lightning, some person is dancing in the planet, and cloud, and my signature, although, yeah. All in all, hope you enjoy my artwork, and have a nice day.
Your imagination is a wonderful thing. It allows you to imagine things your ears don't hear. It allows you to imagine things your eyes don't see. It allows me to imagine what it would be like if we all put a little more love in our hearts.
1, 2, 3, 4. In times of political tension, in times of racial tension, imagine if we all put a little bit more love in our heart. Let's go. think of your fellow man and a helping hand, full of love in your heart. You see it's getting late, oh please don't hesitate, full of love in your heart. And the world will be a better place. And the world will be a better place for you and me. Just wait and see. Another day goes by, still the children cry, full of love in your heart. Hope that you would know, we won't let hatred go, put a little love in your heart. And the world will be a better place. And the world will be a better place for you and me. You just wait and see. Take a look around, that's if you're looking down, full of love in your heart. I hope that you decide, kindness will be your guide, full of love in your heart. And the world will be a better place. And the world will be a better place for you and me. You just wait and see. Let's go. Put a little love in your heart. You got to put a little love in your heart. Put a little love in your heart. You got to put a little love in your heart. You got to put a little love in your heart. Come on now. Put a little love in your heart. Say, put a little love in your heart. Put a little love in your heart.
Hi, I'm Debbie and a junior. My submission goes into the fabric arts section. My project for Can You Imagine is a knotted bookmark with a whale floating over a skyline in the air. Here, that's how it looks now in the end. And if you know anything about friendship bracelet making, that's the back. Here you go. Yeah. When I saw the pattern for this friendship bracelet, the thought of, wow, how genius! And who could imagine this would really happen and like this image would be really possible and like just like real, like it kind of blew my mind. And I had it for a long time in my to-do list. So when Arts Day rolled around, with this topic, I was like, why should I have held back any longer? Let's just make this. And it was fun.
Hey guys, so me and Alex are going to perform a song called Won't Live Here by Daniel Caesar. And pretty much Daniel's talking about this, like, this anonymous person that he seems kind of attached to. And he's kind of saying, like it's almost like he can't live without this person. Like, he doesn't want to live on without this person. And, like, some of the lines are, like, you know, like, don't give up on me now, I'll still get better. And he's kind of saying, like, you know, please don't, like, leave me because I still got growing to do and stuff. And, yes, yeah, so it's kind of, like, I've kind of, like, come to see this song as, like, imagine if I wasn't living with you And then the song is kind of like about how that would be. So yeah, hope you guys enjoy.
Catherine Wenzel, and I'm a junior. My bracelet relates to the theme, Can You Imagine? Because it spurs my imagination. It makes me picture the beautiful blue sky, ocean, and other bodies of water. This is called an arrowhead bracelet pattern, and it took a lot of time to create. The pattern of the arrows flows seamlessly throughout the design, making me imagine how drops of water flow down a river or pour down a waterfall. The colors of this bracelet include several shades of blue and white. They are calming and relaxing colors that make me picture peaceful days at the beach. I hope this bracelet and pattern can help invoke your imagination as well. Thank you.
Hello, my name's Clara, class of 2022. For Arts Day this year, I decided to upcycle a dress. I think that this fits the theme because you can start out with something kind of ugly or something that you're not, that you don't want, and you can make it look really good in the end. And so for my dress, it was just pretty simple to begin with, and I decided that I wanted to make it have a little bit more detail and just a little bit like extra. So I added the ruffles and the straps to it, and I shortened it. And yeah, that's my finished product, and thank you. Bye.
Hi, my name is Cara DiNapoli. I'm a junior, and I wrote a Shakespearean sonnet for Arts Day. I think this fits in well with the theme of imagination because I imagined it to write it. Like, I had to use my imagination. I think that's a pretty good reason. Also, like, I don't know, I like the idea of, like, fairies or pixies or little goblins actually out there that grant your wishes. But, you know, everything comes with a price. And that's just kind of what I base this off of, so... here we go. In a chateau far away from my home, sitting in a garden watched by a dove, glancing out the window as people roamed, wondering if one would be my true love. Seeing the statues with faces so fair in a courtyard full of life all alone, I walked through the garden, stepping with care, for creatures stay hidden under the stones, and they grant wishes of love and desire. They didn't ask for money, they asked for dreams. Dreams grant the wishes that you must acquire, but not every price is what it may seem. So I walk carefully around the stones, content with my life of being alone.
Hi, I'm Tamir, and I decided to do the song Happier by Ed Sheeran. And pretty much what this song talks about in the first part is someone who was just madly in love and they lost their soulmate, and they're starting to realize that this person that they loved is starting to catch feelings for somebody else, and they're seeing them hang out with this person more, and they just regret losing that person. And the second half is pretty much that person trying to play get back, and they're trying to get that person back and just saying that they'll do anything to get this person back, and hopefully the next man messes up just so they can get that chance again. And how I related it to the theme is just, can you just imagine losing pretty much somebody who you thought was your soulmate, and just having to do anything to get that person back, and it just shows how much love can be a drug. So yeah, that's the song I decided to do, and I hope you enjoy it.
You look happy.
Think about a hobby that you used to really enjoy. Something that you used to be pretty good at, but you managed to fall out of love with. For me, it was friendship bracelets. I had made friendship bracelets a lot in middle school and actually well into my sophomore year. I fell really hard out of the craft, and it wasn't until quarantine of March 2020 that I got back into it, and I'm really happy that I found it again. Because I've found a lot of enjoyment in it, and I've actually managed to get pretty good at it.
Do you remember those days where you used to sprint out of your front door when you heard the sound of the ice cream truck? It would be 90 degrees out in the dead of summer. The kids on the block lining up to snag their ice cream treat, looking at all the hundreds of shapes, sizes, flavors, and characters they came in. The ice cream man handed them out, they almost instantly started dripping down your hands. The remains of residue still left on the stick. When I was a kid, I always got one of the crunch popsicles, my favorite being the strawberry crunch popsicle. It had vanilla ice cream with a strawberry ice cream core, and a shortcake crunchy filling the rims. So for Arts Day this year, I made a strawberry crunch cake in replica of my favorite childhood treat. It is a four-layer cake made up of vanilla cake, strawberry filling, vanilla frosting, strawberry shortbread crunchies, and fresh-cut strawberries on top. Can you imagine your childhood treat turned into a cake? What treat would you get?
Can you imagine what we would be like if we believed what God says about us rather than what the world says about us? So often we focus on lies that the world and society tells us. We aren't good enough, we don't fit in, we're not this, we're not that. But the song is a reminder that when we feel weak, He is strong. When we feel like we don't belong, He claims us as His own. In Him, we find strength and identity. Can you imagine how you would feel if you believed what He says about you?
Keep fighting voices in my mind that say I'm not enough. Every single lie that tells me I will never measure up. Am I more than just the sum of every high and every low? Remind me once again just who I am, because I need to know. making all I have, and now I'm laying it at your feet. Ooh.
Imagine waking up and putting on your shoes, knowing that there's nothing in this world you could ever choose over the life you have, because you remember back to the days where your face was concealed by a mask. Turn back to look at the mirror and smile, because for one whole year, it was hidden for quite a while. Treasure the sun, shade, and breeze without the constant fear of catching a disease. As you walk out of the door and throw on your coat, reflect back to the times that trapped you the most. But never forget the strength that grew within every teacher, nurse, and pediatrician. Strap on your seatbelt and start up the car, but please don't let those memories travel too far. Don't let them run away for just another day, because those made you into the person that you are. While driving around in the hustle and bustle of this town, take a moment to cherish the gratitude, appreciation, and love that was found during the year that some may remorse with fear, but you know deep down it was the year that made your life clear and tied your ignorance and oblivion back to the ground. Imagine is a poem about life after COVID-19 is over and how it has affected us and changed our perspectives on the meaning of life. This corresponds with this year's Arts Day theme, which is Imagine If, because as we adjust and live in this constantly changing society, especially in a pandemic, it's important to imagine what life will look like in the future and how our entire outlook on life has shifted. This poem is a reminder to our future selves to never let go of what we have learned and gone through in this past year. Our minds have opened up, our appreciation for the little things has overcome past problems, some of which we can look back at and laugh, and our strength has been tested in every way in the past year. I look forward to seeing how our future plays out, but most importantly, I look forward to always remembering the year that tied my carelessness mind back to the ground. Thank you.
Hi everyone. Me, along with Laura Frederick and Marciela Shalomita, we'll be performing today the song Lifeline by We Three. Lifeline by We Three is a song about dealing with your demons and coming to the realization that sometimes in life it's okay to not be okay. We wanted to sing the song because of its powerful message. Thanks to social media and general society, it is getting harder and harder for people to be real with each other. Too often, we are told to put up a mask and make ourselves look perfect, but imagine if this wasn't true. Imagine if it was normal to respond honestly to the "how are you" greeting that we all use. Imagine if being not okay was embraced instead of hidden. How much would our world change?
Just give in, 'cause I'm barely breathing, got no reason for grieving, that's just how I feel. I'm just trying to be real. Wish I could turn the switch on, leave it on all day long, get it tattooed on my own, just because they told me not to. Wish I could turn you all off, say it without going soft, but we all know that I'm not one to tell you. You have got to shiver, feel it, take it, break it, make it what you wanna. Lose it, choose it, find it, mind it, bruise it, use it, how you gonna? call my lifeline, 'cause I give up. And I'll raise my white flag and just give in, yeah. 'Cause I'm barely breathing, got no reason for grieving, that's just how I feel. I'm just trying to be real. Trying to be real. Wish I believed the things I pray. 9 times out of 10 they're too cliche. But I wouldn't give for a replay. 2 a.m. and still no sleeping. The numbers and figures don't add up. But I'm not really sure if it matters, 'cause lately life's full of disasters. 5 a.m. and still no sleeping. Shiver, feel it, take it, break it, make it what you wanna. Lose it, choose it, find it, find it. Lose it, use it, how you gonna?
Have you ever had this really random idea that for some odd reason you wanted to become a reality? Have you been inspired by somebody to the point of near obsession with the idea that inspired you? I obviously have. Social media in the summer of 2020 was filled with the same amigurumi pattern, a strawberry bee. I saw this, and for an unexplainable reason, I had really wanted to make a strawberry snake. And I had actually completed it and wanted to take it a step further. So I had crocheted an entire collection of fruit snakes and put them in a little fruit bowl.
A Million Dreams from the movie Greatest Showman is a song that encourages imagination. When you think of a dream, you think of a picture or scenario in which you want to see yourself in the future and imagine how you're going to get there. As we move on through life, our dreams and goals seem to run away as we grow up, but we never stop imagining a world and life that is ahead of us. This song goes with the Arts Day theme of Imagine If, because whenever we hear or sing this song, it reminds us to always keep dreaming and imagining up new goals, new adventures, and new possibilities. Laura and I have teamed up for a second year in a row for Arts Day, and we can't wait for you to hear it out.
I close my eyes and I can see a world that's waiting for me. That I call my own. Through the dark, through the door, through where no one's been before, and it feels like home. They can say it all sounds crazy. They can say I've lost my mind. I don't care if they call me crazy. We can live in a world that we design. 'Cause every night I lie in bed, the brightest colors fill my head. A million dreams are keeping me awake.
be a vision of the one I see. A million dreams is all it's gonna take. A million dreams for the world we're gonna make. There's a house we can build. Every room inside is filled with things from far away. Special things I compile, each one there to make you smile on a rainy day. They can say it all sounds crazy. They can say you've lost our minds. I don't care if they call us crazy. Run away to a world that we design. Cause every night I lie in bed, the brightest colors fill my head. A million dreams are keeping me awake. I think of what the world could be, a vision of the one I see. A million dreams is all it's gonna take. A million dreams for the world we're gonna make.
However big, however small, let me be a part of it all. Share your dreams.
Rodriguez.
I'm Lydia King.
And for our Arts Day project, we decided to make funnel cake.
We decided to make funnel cake because we thought it looked like a brain, and a brain fits well with the theme of imagination.
So yeah, thanks. Yeah. We hope you enjoyed.
Hello, I'm Emma Rose Thompson. I'm a senior, and this is my entry for Fabric Arts. Can you imagine? Have you ever wondered if you could fly? Maybe as a kid while on a swing set going back and forth, or looking up at the sky watching the birds? Or how about when you were on a plane looking out at the clouds? What would you do if you could fly? Well, I tried to make that idea somewhat real. These wings that are scaled to my size are made out of PVC pipe, electronic actuators, and battery pack. They are covered in feathers that are made by not tying cotton rope, brushing out each feather, then dyeing them. The dress and the bags that the feathers are on were all sewn by me. This dress is designed to hide the harness that supports the wings. These are the wings that I would want if I could fly. Colored orange to resemble a phoenix that rises from its ashes. They expand as if in flight. How would you imagine what your wings would look like? Would they be small or large, multicolored or a natural shape? It is all up to your imagination. Now, can you imagine?
Warning, the following show features stunts performed either by professionals or under the supervision of professionals. Accordingly, MTV and the producers must insist that no one attempt to recreate or reenact any stunt or activity performed on this show.
Hi, my name is Luke Sharp. I'm a senior, and this is my Arts Day photo. So, the theme of this Arts Day is, can you imagine? And my picture abides by this theme very well, I think, because you have machinery made by man and nature made by God mixed into one picture that makes it look beautiful. You have the car blocking out the sun, but yet you still have the sunset in the background, which I think just makes for the perfect picture. Show the bond between man and God.
Can you imagine baking the perfect cake with only measuring the baking powder?
We can.
Because we did it.
Hi, I'm Savon Dirksen.
Hi, I'm Kylie Gottschall.
And we are
seniors.
Enjoy.
Here is the circular pan that we made our cake in.
Then we preheated the oven. 350 degrees Fahrenheit.
Sugar.
Butter.
Eggs.
Mint extract.
Old purpose flour.
Baking powder.
Then we put the sugar and the butter into a bowl so that we could mix it. It was about a half a cup of butter and I don't know how much sugar.
Then we mixed.
Then we threw in 2 eggs. Mix.
Cocoa powder.
Mint extract. Cocoa powder.
Milk.
Flour. About 3 heaping scoops. Mix. Fold.
Baking powder.
We did do 2 teaspoons of baking powder. Fold.
More milk.
little folding, spray.
Pouring the ingredients into the pan. Covered the bottom.
Baker's chocolate. Then we put it into the top of the cake. Minutes and 54 seconds left.
Then we put it in the oven.
Then we made the icing out of milk and powdered sugar and then cocoa powder. And then Kylie put it in the fridge. 10 minutes left. Water break. Dirty.
Clean. Then it came out of the oven.
Icing time.
Then we flipped the cake onto the platter.
Then icing. And then done.
Sort of ta-da! The reason why you call this.
Hi everyone. My name is Sarah Kennell, and for Arts Day this year, I chose to do a piece with Song Kang, covering the song Distance by Emily King. Can you imagine if you were still here? Distance by Emily King articulates the emotions of experiencing a relationship separated by distance. We chose to use a similar interpretation and apply it to our current situation. Song used to stay with our family here in Pennsylvania, where we became like siblings, but had to return home during COVID. He has not been able to return, now having been in South Korea for almost a year. In communicating and completing this project, the difference in time zone proved to be a difficult hurdle. Despite this, the time we spent working together made us feel at moments like he had never left. The idea behind our music video to use roads allows the audience to imagine that we are still in the same place, while still showing the difference in time zone by contrast of day and night. We hope you enjoy what we've created. Ooh.
still